Hello, it's Anita from digingin.com and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a professionally looking ebook cover in PowerPoint. I'm using PowerPoint 2016, but you can find similar functionality also in older PowerPoint versions. Open a new PowerPoint presentation and delete all text boxes. Then go to Design section, Slide Size, and choose Custom Slide Size. Scroll down and choose Custom again. As you can see, PowerPoint offers only centimeters, or you maybe have inches as a size measurement. But we need pixels. Many ebook cover designers suggest using the following dimensions for your cover design: 1870 to 2500 pixels. It will work well on all bookselling platforms, including Amazon. In order to set the correct size in PowerPoint, you need to convert pixels to centimeters or inches if you use imperial units. Go to Google and search for pixels to centimeters or inches and open one of these converters. Insert your numbers and convert them to centimeters and then use them in PowerPoint. Here. PowerPoint is asking if you want to maximize the size of your content or scale it down to ensure it would fit on the new slide. Since you don't have any content yet, you can choose whichever option you want. And now you see that the page orientation and dimensions have changed according to your needs. Now insert a new text box and write your book title. I'll select it and increase its size so you can see it better. And I'll change the text to uppercase. And make it even bigger by clicking on this button. Therefore, I don't need to try guessing the right font size. And now I'll insert my image, which I have downloaded from dreamstime.com. You can find the link to this webpage under the video. It's a rather good resource of royalty-free stock images and cheaper than many similar resources. By clicking on the dot in the corner and dragging, I'll increase the size of my image so that it covers all my page. As you can see, the height is okay now, but the width is too wide. Therefore, I'll crop it. At first, I'll move it so that I can see the borders of my page. And now I'll adjust its size. I want this cute robot to be seen only partly on my cover. Therefore, I'll cut it off a little bit. And now I'll place the image precisely on my book cover. I can't see my title anymore because the image has covered it. Therefore, I'll click on it with the right button of my mouse and we'll send it to back. And here is my title. I want to change the tonality of my picture to make it warmer and more inviting. I'll click on it with the right button of my mouse to open form a picture. Now I'll go to this image icon and then to picture color and to presets. I'll choose this one. You can also play with other options here, for example, saturation, temperature, or with color tone presets. But I don't need all these changes, so I'll undo them by clicking on this arrow. Now I'll format my title. I'll choose this font, increase it, and align it to the left margin like this. And I'll format my tagline. I'll use eyedropper to get this orange color from the image. Because it's always advisable to use the same colors that are in your picture to maintain coherent color scheme. Read more about creating good-looking color schemes in my blog post. The link is included in the video description below. I need to insert one more text box to write the author's name. It looks very small, but I'll quickly increase it by clicking on this button. And I'll change the font to the same that I used for my title text. Now I'll align it to the left according to the title. And basically that's all. If you want to play with other fonts or design, simply duplicate the slide and do it here so that you can compare them afterwards and choose the one you like more. I want to use the font Oswald because it looks very good on book covers and is easily readable. In order to get your book cover file in JPG or PNG format that you will be able to upload on Amazon or any other book publishing site, go to File, Export and change file type to the JPG format. If you wish, you can choose many other file formats as well, including PDF and PNG. But I'll use JPG in this case. And click Save. Here PowerPoint asks me if I want to save only one slide or all of them. I want to save only this one. If you choose to save all slides, then PowerPoint will generate a zip folder with all slides in your chosen format in it. And that's all. If you want to learn how to spend less time on Twitter marketing, buy this book on Amazon. It will cost you just $1, but it's going to save you a lot of time and money. You can find the link below in the video description. And don't forget to save your PowerPoint file to access it later and make changes whenever you want. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up to let me know and help more people to find it. Feel free to share this video with anybody you think it might be helpful. To see more videos with great tips on how to easily create beautiful visuals and be more productive, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I post videos every week about free tools for creating visuals and increasing your productivity on the internet and social media. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Anita Nippon from Diginen.com. I hope to see you next time.